Live from Cleveland, this is Progressive Field. MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the New York Mets taking on the Cleveland Guardians. First pitch coming your way next. Just a little bit away from first pitch. And on the mound today, number 39.
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot, the same tunnel, and that can make life very difficult on his opponents.
And another ball.
Three balls, one strike.
Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Swinging and one out now.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Just missed.
Got two balls, one strike.
Fouled off, 2-2. And a ground ball to first. He steps on the bag, 2 up, 2 down. Let's take a peek at the Mets lineup here. We could be in for a power showcase today with the wind blowing out a lot of lift and separate, Chris.
Well, we know guys are in this era definitely trying to hit the ball in the air regardless of the conditions, but I think even a little more so there's margin for error if you can get the ball up in the air. So, you know, you'll see at times, I'm sure, with two strikes, what looks like a half swing that can get out of the ballpark with a guy who's got decent
ball. Three balls, one strike.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone. A massive home run. And just like that, they're out front. It's 1-0.
Pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Base is empty with two away. Here's Pete Alonso. Two outs. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And the right-hander deals. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Two down, base is empty, but one run across, and we're just getting started here in the top of the first. Swings and misses. Couldn't catch up to the heater. The Mets do pick up a run on this solo blast. It's now 1-0. You're dialed into the show. Back now at Progressive Field. And on the hill in this one, Luis Severino. What do you have on him?
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
And two another ball.
Two strikes.
Up and in, and the count's full. Hawaii to kick the pitch. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Severino kicks, deals. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Did it get an off ball? Now he has somebody to worry about over first.
And now it's even up.
Three ball.
This one in the dirt, and the runner holds. Roll to short, could be two. Over to McNeil. Over to Alonzo. Double play.
Well, almost any time you roll over and send a two ball to short at this level, you can pretty much count on a double play. Middle infielders are just so reliable, and they work on these plays all the time, so it almost becomes like second nature.
Now it's Jose Ramirez. And a pitch. Way inside. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Two down, nobody on. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. Severino. Caught him looking for the K. Here in Cleveland, and now the right fielder, Tyrone Taylor.
Number 15, Tyrone Taylor.
Here's a 1-1.
Ball two. Two balls, one strike.
Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Now up to hit, Francisco Lindor. 1-1 now. Next offering is outside. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss as he was out front. Yeah. And another ball. And he deals. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Mariano makes the play.
That is cut. The left fielder, number 9, Brandon Nimmo.
Here's Brandon Nimmo. Left-hand batter waits. That one finds the zone, and the count is 1-2.
So far, all we've seen in this at-bat are fastballs. Look for him to slow it down right here ahead in the count.
Off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2. Man at first, one away. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball, and I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location, but he found a way to just get it by him.
Here's the third baseman, Brett Beatty. Swings through that one.
One ball, two strikes.
Taylor, the runner at first with two gone. Fights that one away, still 1-2.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Here's a 1-2. Gets a piece and stays alive. Two outs. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that'll do it. Mets strand one, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Here in Cleveland, and now the first baseman, Josh Naylor.
The first baseman, Josh Naylor.
Righty delivers. That misses. Helps. And that's ball three. Swung on. Popped up on the infield. McNeil settles underneath it. Puts it away for the out.
That was a good hard fastball with some nice ride up at the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop up and an easy out for the defense.
Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. And Laureano is retired. And there's two down.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Bo Naylor at the plate now. Two down, nobody on. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And another ball. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. A wind and a pitch. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Wouldn't Full chase count. That time. Five foul balls in this at bat so far, and these two are going head to head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little bit more and more each pitch, even though there hasn't been a ball in play yet. Three, two. Laced down the line. Could be extra bases. Around first, digging for two. Throws to second, but he's in there easily. But when you see that many pitches in an at-bat, your chances of succeeding go up. And right there, we see the result. Kyle Manzardo will hit next. Man on second, two down. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
One ball, two strikes.
Kicks and fires.
Four, that's inside.
Still in the second, already at 44 pitches, so some concern there.
That's a little bit low. Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Tyler Freeman to bat next. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Hit hard on the ground is short. Rolls across the diamond. That's the third out. A double in the inning, but they leave him stranded. We head on down to the top of the third. It's the Mets one and the Guardians nothing. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top half of the third inning. Tomas Nito at the plate. Fouled off down the right side. Pitch. A little bit low. It's a good take.
Two balls, two strikes.
Not close with that one, and it's 3-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And a pitch. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. He's got it. And there's one away.
The batter, the center fielder, Harrison.
And now Bader up to the plate. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. That's to third. Ramirez sends it to first. And Bader is set down.
Now back. Second base. Jeff McNeil.
And now here's Jeff McNeil. Two down, nobody on. We're here in the top half of inning number three. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The wind of the pitch. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout. And the Mets go down 1-2-3. They lead it 1-0. Set for the bottom of the third. And now here is Tyler Freeman.
Tyler.
You and I got a chance to broadcast the 2019 All-Star Game, and the city of Cleveland did such a great job. I felt like wherever you turned, there was some type of ad for the All-Star Game, a face of one of the players playing in the game. I thought the city overall supported the event really well. Here's Brian Rocchio. Home team down a run here in the last half of the third. Next offering is in for a strike.
Yeah, and I think the players backed it up from the home run derby and the show that was put on between Vladimir Guerrero Jr., Pete Alonso, and others. It was off the charts. And then the game is always special. When you see the best in baseball, you remember how special this game is. And to be here at this ballpark, I think just was the icing on the cake.
And that's outside, and it's 2-1. That one missed.
One strike.
Two outs, bases empty. And that drops in for a strike.
Okay.
Two. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
Boom, the runner at first needs to be careful right here. He's dealing with the pickoff artist on the mound.
Two outs. Fouls it off. Still 1-2. Big slack center field. Brennan around second, headed for third. Coming home. The relay. He scores and the Guardians tie it up. It's 1-1.
Comes through with the RBI. Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive in the center field. So that definitely felt good.
A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
Here's Jose Ramirez. The 2-1. Yeah. And he takes a strike.
2-2, yeah.
Runner at second, two down. Next pitch is downstairs. Josh Naylor waits on deck. Three and two now. Chopper right side. Alonso tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. And Ramirez is set down. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. And we're back. Start of the fourth. Now it's J.D. Martinez.
J.D. Martinez.
The wind of the pitch. Fouled off. He was late.
He's been pitching well, but going through this middle of the order second time through, we'll see what kind of adjustments are being made.
Here's the 2-2. Stays alive.
Pretty much had to offer it that way. You don't want to leave it in the air. umpire's hands. Even though it ended up outside the zone, it still was close enough to where it looked like it could drop down right on that corner and get the call. Last thing you want to do is get punched out by the umpire, knowing you could have at least fouled the pitch off and kept the at-bat going.
And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. Smoked on the ground a second, and that takes care of Alonso.
Now bat right fielder, Tyrone Taylor.
Now it's the right fielder, Tyrone Taylor. Ball tied up, top half of inning number four. Falling behind, 2-1. Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone. And another ball. And there's ball four.
Now back.
Francisco Lindor to the plate now. Fans love him, but he's pretty popular with the players, too.
He certainly is, Boog. The player survey on MLB.com listed him as one of the friendliest infielders to chat with during a game. I'm sure he appreciates the recognition from his peers.
And that one is lifted in the air. Brennan racing over to make the catch. Mets lead one. Score remains deadlocked at one. Here in Cleveland, stepping in, Josh Naylor.
The first baseman.
The pitch. Pets it misses. It's a strikeout. Laureano comes up to hit.
The right field.
Bounce to third. Baden tosses across to first, and that quickly two away.
Now that the catch. Whoa.
Bo Naylor now at the plate. Two down, nobody on. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Two now.
Ball two.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. Guardians go down in order. Guardians fail to score. Score remains tied 1-1. Now at Progressive Field. We go to the top of the fifth. Now the left fielder, Brandon Nimmo. The 1-1. There's a strike. Action in the pen down there. Pedro Avila, the young right-hander, up and throwing. Gattis warming up as well. And a 1-2. Got him looking, and he did not like the call.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a cold ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
One down, base is empty. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. And the pitch. That misses. Yeah, that's ball two. Battling here as he fouls it away. The pitch. lifted in the air right center field. Laureano settles under it, makes the grab for the second out. Next to him, Tomas Nido. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position, and that's what he does.
That goes down looking. Mets go down quickly. Still tied, 1-1. Here in Cleveland, John Chavi with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, Kyle Manzardo. Here's a 1-1. On the ground, right side. Alonso takes it himself, and the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Tyler Freeman.
Here's Tyler Freeman to hit. The pitch. And another ball.
Oh, they have had a hard time scoring in this one. The pitcher out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
Next offering is in for a strike.
This game has been so tight, it feels like the next team to score will win it.
Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number five. And that's ball four.
Ball four.
Well, he's starting to look a little gassed to me, and we'll see if they go to the bullpen in this spot or not.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Luis Severino won't go any further. Only two hits allowed for him, so a great effort. And we'll be back after a quick break to tell you about the new arm. Pitching change here, Sean Reed Foley.
Number 71, Sean Reed Foley.
Stepping up for the Guardians, Ryan Rocchio. And here it comes. Runner takes off. Swing and a miss. Throw save. That's a stolen base. Two now. Will Brennan on deck for the Guardians. Freeman, the runner at second with one away. On the ground, right side. Tosses to first. He's out.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at-bat.
Now a chance for Will Brennan. Runner at third, two away. Two outs. Fights it off. You'll see another. One, two now. hit. The run scores from third, and a 2-1 ball game now.
Well done. Drives in the run. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Two outs, runner on first. Here's Andrés Giménez. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
Righty to the plate.
That's ball two.
That misses the zone. And now 3-2.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Left-hand hitter waits. That one is absolutely belted. Way back there. And that one's gone. And they add on. It's 4-1.
And that shot makes their grip on the lead even tighter. Hit at the plate, even if it's a borderline pitch. You don't want to leave it in the umpire's hands. Got to be ready to pull the trigger. He had a great swing on that, and he got rewarded for it.
And here is Jose Ramirez. Aye. Down to the dirt, swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
In the air to left center, Bader sizes this one up, and that will end the inning. Cleveland with a pair on this blast. It's now a 4-1 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Nick Sandlin.
Number 52, Nick Sandler.
Harrison Bader up now for the Mets. The Mets in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
In the air, left field. Brennan has a beat on it. Calls it in for the out. And there's one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. And a count, 1-2.
Well, in this one, the offense has sputtered. Somebody's got to find a way to get on, keep the line moving, and manufacture at least one run. Then maybe you get two or three.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field. Rocchio calls it in, and there's two away.
Now that designated hitter, J.D. Martinez.
J.D. Martinez stands in. The Mets trailing by three, and we're the top half of the sixth. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Nothing doing here this half. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. Guardians 4 and the Mets 1. Back now for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Reed Garrett.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Here's Josh Naylor.
Leading off for the Guardians, the first baseman,
Chuck Naylor.
And the pitch. It's softly on the ground left side. No play. That's an infield single.
It doesn't really matter where you are in the lineup. Your job is to get on base and try to start a rally if you're leading off an inning. So an infield single does the job right there. Now we'll see if they can make something happen.
Here's Ramon Laureano at the belt and fires. And that's downstairs and outside.
2-2 to count.
Right-handed reliever just misses with that one. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Jorge Lopez preparing to come on if needed. Sulcer also getting ready. So now 3-2. Got him looking. That's a strikeout.
Fastball inside just freezes the hitter. I don't think he was ready to pull the trigger. A lot of times hitters are looking away. And that one locked him up.
Digging in, Bo Naylor. Naylor stands at first with one out. And another ball. There's a swing and a drive. Way back there.
Excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin throwed it out of here.
Next for the Guardians is the designated hitter, Kyle Mansardo. And the right-hander deals. That's out to center field. Bader should have it. And he makes the catch. Two away.
The batter, the center fielder.
Tyler Freeman digs in for the Guardians.
Freeman.
The 1-2. This one popped up. Moving under this one. And that is that. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run homer. And this is now a 6-1 ball game. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Scott Barlow.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
And stepping in for New York, Pete Alonso. Right through there for a strike.
That front door slider is such a devastating pitch. You don't want to get beat by the inside fastball, so you cheat a little bit, and then by the time it gets there, it's out of the swing plane.
Struck him out of the front door breaking ball.
Well, this is no secret. That slider is going to be his go-to pitch. Everyone in the ballpark knows it. It's a massive part of his arsenal, and he'll throw it a lot and in pretty much any count, any situation, and he's going to look to punch guys out as well. I tell you what, the effectiveness of that slider is always a big key for him.
And a swing and a miss. Movement in the bullpen. Tim Herron, the left-hander, is getting that big fastball of his ready to go. Number 36, a right-hander. Loosening up as well. A wide to kick the pitch. And another ball. Base is empty, one away. Here at the top half of inning number 7. Here's a rocket out to left. Snags it for the second out. So last chance for the Mets. Francisco Lindor up now for the Mets. Ball to strike. Gets under it and pops it up. Rocchio settles under this one. Ball game.
I don't care if you're a top team or you're a middle of the pack team. Every ball club wants to be dominant at home. Winning a game like this just helps to boost the confidence and makes you look forward to coming out again for the next one.
6-1 is your final here today. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
The final round for this afternoon's ball game. First, for the victorious Cleveland Guardians, six runs, six hits, no errors, they left.